Mr. Hale, before we move things about, could you explain to Mr. Henderson just what you saw when you came here yesterday morning?
By the way, has anything been moved? Are things just the way you left them yesterday?
It's just the same. When it dropped below zero last night, I sent Frank over here to make a fire for us. No use getting pneumonia with a big case on, and I told Frank not to touch anything to the stove. You know, Frank.
Somebody should have been left here yesterday.
Oh, yesterday. When I said Frank after that man who went crazy, I want you to know I had my hands full yesterday. I knew you'd get back from Omaha by today, and as long as I knew I'd go over everything here myself.
Oh, Mr. Hale, tell just what happened with that place.
Well, Harry and I started the town with a load full of potatoes. We came along the road from my place, and as we got there, I said, I'm going to see if I can't get John Wright to go in with me on a party. Come on,
let's talk about that later, Mr. Hale. I do want to talk about that. Just tell now what happened when you got here.
Well, I didn't see or hear anything. I knocked at the door. Well, I knew they must be up. It was past 8 o'clock. So I knocked again. I thought I heard somebody say, come in. I wasn't sure. Not sure yet. But I opened the door. And there in that rocker sat Mrs. Wright.
What was she doing?
She was rocking back and forth. She had her apron in her hand and was kind of pleading.
And how did she look?
Well, she looked queer.
How do you mean queer?
As if she didn't know what she was going to do. Next. Kind of done up.
And how did she seem to feel about your coming?
Well, I don't think she minded one way or the other. I said, how do, Mrs. Wright? It's cold, ain't it? And she said, is it? I just went on pleading at her apron. I told her that I'd come to see John. And then she left. I guess she was cold and left. I said, well, why can't I see him? Of course, he's dead, she says. Dead, says I? Just lying ahead. Upstairs, and there he was lying.
I think I'd rather have you go into that upstairs, where you can point it all out. Just go on now with the rest of the story.
Well, my first thought was to get the rope off. But Harry said, no, he's dead all right, and we better not touch anything. So we came back downstairs. Who did this, Mrs. Wright? Harry says, look. I don't know, she says.
You don't know, says Harry?
No, she says. Weren't you sleeping in the bedroom, says Harry?
Somebody slipped a rope around his neck and strangles him and you didn't wake up?
No, she says. We must have looked as if we couldn't see how that could be, for after a minute she said, I sleep sound. Well, that's when I said maybe we ought to let her tell a story first to the coroner or to the sheriff. So Harry went as fast as he could to Rivers Place where there's a telephone.
And what did Mrs. Wright do when she knew you had gone to the coroner?
Well, she moved from that rocker to that chair over there. We just sat there with our hands held together looking down. I told her that I'd come to see if John wanted to put in a telephone, but that just left her laugh. And when she looked at me, she was scared.
Oh, I don't know, maybe he wasn't scared. I wouldn't like to say it was.
Well, soon Harry got back and Dr. Lloyd came, and you, Mr. Peters, so I guess that's all I know that you know.
I guess we'll go upstairs first, then out to the barn around there. You're convinced that there was nothing here, nothing that would point to any motive?
Nothing here but kitchen things.
It is a nice mess.
Oh, the fruit. It did freeze. She worried about that when it turned so cold. She said the fire would go out of the charge of
the room. Well, can you beat the woman? Held for murder and worried about it preserved.
I guess before we're through, she may have something more serious than preserves.
Well, women are used to worrying over trifles.
And yet, for all their worries, what would we do without the ladies? Dirty towels. Not much of a housekeeper, would you say, ladies?
There's a great deal of work to be done on the farm.
Ah, going to your sex, I see. But you and Mrs. Wright are neighbors, I suppose you're friends.
I haven't seen much of her lately. I haven't been in this house for over a year.
Why was that?
Oh, I liked her well enough. Farmers' wives had their hands full, Mr. Henderson. And then it really... Well, it never seemed a very cheerful place.
No, it's not cheerful. I shouldn't say she had no home in this.
Well, I don't know his right hand either.
You mean that he came along very well?
No, I don't mean anything. But I don't think a place would be any cheerfuler for John Wright being in.
I'd like to talk more about it a little later. Now I want to get the lay of things upstairs.
I guess anything Mrs. Peters does will be all right. She was taking some clothes for her, and, you know, little things. We left in such a hurry yesterday.
Yes, but I would like to see what you take in, Mrs. Peters, and keep an eye out for anything that might be useful.
Mr.
signs of anger around here. I wonder how they're finding things upstairs. I hope she had a little more fixed up there. You know, it seems kind of sneaky. Locking her up in town, and then coming out here, trying to get her own home to turn against her.
But Mrs. Hale, the law is the law.
I suppose it is.
He was wondering if she was going to Quilton or just not.
Frank's why I didn't do too much up there, did it? Let's go out to the barn and get that cleared up.
Well, I don't think there's anything so strange. Thor are taking up our time with little things. All waiting for them to get the evidence. Of course, they've got all the important things on their minds. Mrs. Peters. Look at this one. This is the one she was working on. All the rest has been done so nice and even. And look at this, it's all over the place. Why, it looks as if she didn't know what she was about.
What are you doing, Sam?
Just pulling out a stitch or two that wasn't sewed very good. Hand sewing always makes me fidgety. Just gonna finish up in a sec. What do you suppose she was so nervous about?
Oh, I didn't know she was nervous. I said that's awful cool, but I'm just tired. Well, let's get this thing wrapped up. The lady keeps doing what you think. I wonder if I can find this paper. It's absurd.
In that cupboard, maybe? superstitious, you know. They leave.
No sign at all of anyone coming from the outside. Now let's go up again and go over it piece by piece. It would have had to have been someone who knew just where everything was. Clear except for a reason for doing it. And you know juries when it comes to women. There is some definite thing. Something to show. Something to make a story. Something to connect up with a strange way of doing it.
Well, to get the team around. Pretty cold out there.
I'm going to stay here all by myself. You can't send Frank out when you can't hear.
You want to see what Mrs. Peters is going to take in?
Oh, I guess they're not very dangerous things the ladies have picked out. No, Mrs. Peters doesn't need supervising. For that matter, a sheriff's wife is married to the law. Ever think of that way, Mrs. Peters?
Married to the law? I want you to come in here for a minute, George. I want you to take a look at these windows.
Oh, windows.
We'll be right out.